Greetings everyone, my name is Rob Griffiths and I'm a senior editor at Macworld. On this installment of the Macworld video, I'm going to be discussing OS X, in particular OS 10.5.2, the latest point release for Leopard. Now, when 10.5 came out, there were a lot of things about it that I really liked. The improvements to Spotlight, with the ability to search on phrases and to use Boolean operators, Quick Look in the Finder, which has changed the way I interact with my Mac, the ability to do screen sharing, both in the Finder with other machines in the household and with relatives miles away across iChat, a great technology. So a lot of good news on the 10.5 front. But on the other side, there were some changes that weren't necessarily so well received. iCal got a new interface, which quite frankly I'm still having trouble getting used to. And we gained a translucent menu and translucent menu bar, which are things that I'm not sure anyone was actually asking for. And there's also the loss of hierarchical folders in the dock. You know, we used to be able to have a folder with a pop-up menu in it, and that was replaced with stacks. And stacks isn't necessarily a bad feature, but to give up a feature that everyone had been using was sort of difficult for a lot of users to adjust to. So what does any of this have to do with 10.5.2? Well, in case you haven't heard, with the release of 10.5.2, Apple actually made changes in the operating system, something that, quite honestly, I don't remember them doing with a past minor point release where they seemed to have listened to the will of the users. And so there were changes made in the way 10.5.2 operates in many areas, including stacks and including translucency. So I'm going to take a few minutes today to cover some of the new features and a couple of tips to get the most out of 10.5.2. As I mentioned earlier, this is a large update. Here's Apple's update page for 10.5.2. As you can see, it's a long page. There are 76 items listed here, some bug fixes and some are new features. The URL for this page is in our show notes. Anyway, this is a substantial update weighing in at 350 megabytes if you want the combined updater, so there's a lot of information here. We're going to focus not on the bug fixes, but on the new features. The first new feature we're going to talk about is the Time Machine menu bar icon. Prior to this feature being added, you had to use the FireWire hard drive in the sidebar or Time Machine's preferences to do things like start a backup or see the status of a backup. Now you just click an icon in the menu bar and you can choose to backup now, enter Time Machine's interface, or open Time Machine's preferences. And if you hold down the Option key, you can actually browse other Time Machine disks. To start a backup, select Backup Now, and you'll notice that the icon in the menu bar starts spinning. And in a typical Apple Touch, it actually spins counterclockwise to let you know you're able to go back in time. The second new feature I'd like to talk about is the translucent menu bar, or rather, the ability to remove the translucent menu bar. As you can see here, I must have a bright desktop picture that goes from yellow to purple because you can see it behind my menu bar. But to get rid of it, you just need to go to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensaver, and down at the bottom there's a new checkbox to disable the translucent menu bar. Simply click to remove the checkmark, and when you go back to the Finder, you'll find that your menu bar is no longer translucent. I don't know about you, but I find it much easier to work with a menu bar that's not constantly showing me what's hiding behind it. To me, even more annoying than the menu bar was the fact that the menus themselves were translucent. But as you can see in this image, that's no longer the case. On the left is a 10.5 menu, and on the right, a 10.5.2 menu. As you can see, the translucency has been greatly reduced, making it much easier to read the menu items themselves without the background clutter showing through. I think this is a great change. The final thing we're going to talk about today are stacks, specifically the changes Apple's made to stacks in 10.5.2. Now, as you know, stacks sit in the dock and spring to life when clicked on, and their behavior is much different than folders in the dock in 10.4. Let's take a look at some stacks. I have downloads, documents, and servers in my dock, and in 10.5, here's how they behave. I'd see a fan or a grid that popped up when I clicked my mouse, but I couldn't navigate into anything, in this case, my servers folder that I connect to shares on these machines. They would open in the Finder if clicked. Now, the other problem with stack is when you drop something into one, the icon changes, so you're never quite sure which folder is which. But with 10.5.2, Apple's taking care of this problem by making changes to Stack's contextual menu. In the Display As section, if you change the selection from Stack to Folder, then that object's icon will not change when new items are added to it. And there's a new entry in the View Content As section. Select List to bring back 10.4's hierarchical folder behavior. So now folders in the dock can either be stacks or hierarchical, and they can have fixed or changing icons. This is a great solution to the problem. Now let's take a look at how this works in practice with my three docked folders. We'll start with the Downloads folder, which had the changed icon. By using the Display As section and setting it to Folder, The icon will no longer change, and I have my Downloads icon. Now, we'll take a look at the Documents folder. I'd really like to be able to navigate, so I want this to be a hierarchical folder, as in 10.4, so I just choose List, and there are all the items in my Documents folder. However, I also want the icon to be fixed, so I'm going to change this to be a folder as well, and there's that icon. Finally, servers need to behave as a list with a fixed folder as well, in this case a custom icon that I've attached. Now I can get directly to the shares on both of my machines through an easy-to-use pop-up menu, just as I could in 10.4. But there's a bonus feature. You can still sort by name, date added, date modified, or kind, even for folders that are behaving as hierarchical. You couldn't do this in 10.4. Well, if you'll pardon the pun, there's a really quick look at OS 10.5.2. Personally, I'm thrilled with this point release from Apple. I think it brings 10.5 to a level where it's usable by anyone, and I will recommend 10.5 upgrades for those who have been contemplating them. Now is the time to switch. But more important than the features that the update brings, I think it's the attitude of Apple that I'm most pleased with. That is, for the first time that I can recall, they seem willing to make changes based on customer feedback, and that can only bode well for the future of 10.5. Until next time, this is Rob Griffiths, signing off.